Steve's jaw dropped to the ground for not the first time in the last 5 minutes, as, all at once, the disembodied voices were now no longer disembodied at all. The two-headed nymph materialized right in front of him. It was huge! As Steve squinted his eyes and craned his neck towards the forest canopy above, the two-headed nymph suddenly decided to burst into song.
Oh Steve, I can see by that look in your eyes that the state of play you see today has come as some surprise. I don't know what you thought you'd find so far deep into this wood, but to save the princess now you must, and I hope that's understood. Oh Steve, oh Steve, yes Steve, oh Steve, we know that you can be the man to bring about some change. Oh Steve, yes Steve, it's true dear Steve, that you are here to swallow fear and step into the strange.
Okay, this is all very well, two-headed nymph. Sorry, I don't know your name, said Steve.
Sylvia?
I see. Pleased to meet you.
The pleasure's all ours.
And I'd love to help, but from what I can see, the princess is locked up in a towering stone tower with no visible access point, and the tower itself is guarded by an army of singing dwarves who don't seem to give off a particularly friendly air. I'm not entirely sure what you intend on me doing in order to save the day.
We were coming to that.
Were you?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It goes a little something like...
Oh, Steve! You please, in the dense undergrowth, you're sure to find, if you be so kind, I swear on our troth, the perfect thing to aid you in your quest so new and true, a giant bouncy mushroom that'll get you straight through the window. Oh Steve, hey Steve, look Steve, we get that this seems unfeasible, but take a moment now to think. Dear Steve, lovely Steve, our Steve, in the contents of all the other things, this is incongruous how.
Wow. So I'm going to bounce off that giant mushroom over there, right by that especially scary-looking sentry dwarf, get completely the right angle, force and height, etc. on the first bounce so as not to arouse any unnecessary suspicion, head straight through the currently closed window, and then what?
Grab the princess, jump back out of the window, onto the mushroom, and then run off out of the woods.
Righto. Well, it's worth a go, I suppose. I mean, what could go wrong?
Precisely.
Can't say I'm one to turn down a challenge at any rate, and I'm sure I'll be back in time for me to do the rest of today's work. Do I need to drop the princess off anywhere or anything, and why exactly has the princess been locked up in the tower in the first place, did you say?
I didn't.
You didn't?
No.
But you're going to tell me now, aren't you?
How did you guess?
I had a hunch.
Oh Steve, once she's free, I don't know what's next, but legend says that within the tower lies a portentous text. The contents of that hidden tome will reveal all you see, and somehow that's wrong and right as is customary. So Steve, that's it, we have shared all I know, and somehow it feels as if it's time I should go. It's almost like our raison d'etre has come to an end, and I'll be at peace now you've proven a friend.
And with that, the two-headed nymph was gone.